Thank you for choosing MetalCloak. Today we are going to install the 3.5-inch Game Changer ARB Edition Suspension Kit for the JK Wrangler. Important note, to install lift components you will need to fully droop your suspension in the front and rear, though not necessarily at the same time. We strongly recommend that the vehicle be placed on an automotive lift and that all appropriate safety precautions be taken. This video is intended to be a supplement to the printed instructions available on MetalCloakInstructions.com. First, we will remove the stock components. Disconnect the front sway bar links. Unbolt the brake line bracket from the frame so you don't stretch the brake line. Remove the front track bar. Remove the stock shocks. Now remove the stock springs and any spacers that may have been used. A note here on control arms. MetalCloak ships the Aduraflex control arms at the approximate length for 3.5-inch lift kits. If you are doing a 2.5-inch kit, the control arms may need to be adjusted. However, if you do not know the full dynamics of how to set up your control arms, please take your Jeep to a professional for adjusting your caster and aligning your suspension. Next, we will swap out the old control arms. You can do this one control arm at a time. Start by using an 18mm socket to remove the stock bolts from the upper arms. You will need a socket extension to access the head of the upper bolt inside the frame. Install the upper arms, putting the clevis towards the stock bushings on the axle. Remove the stock hardware in the lower control arms. We are going to reuse this hardware on the new control arms. Install the lower front control arms as shown so that the short bend is in the rear, and the arm angles inboard to provide tire turning clearance. Next, we will install the front adjustable bump stops and coils. Center the puck on the top of the coil spring perch and mark the center of the hole. Drill a 1/2-inch hole to mark locations. It is best to step up using increasingly larger drill bits until the 1/2-inch hole is achieved. Now, install your new dual rate coils. The coils are designed so the tight stack sits at the top. Make sure the coil is sitting in the pocket on the axle mount. Note, you can easily distinguish the coils in the front of the JK from those on the rear by their size. Your front coils are taller than your rear coils. Once your coils are in, you can install the bump stops to your chosen height by sticking one puck in at a time. Next, we will install the long travel Old Man Emu shocks. Put the upper shock pin through the upper tower first and bolt into place. However, do not tighten just yet. By the way, it may be necessary to clip some of the plastic engine guard components above the shock tower in order to access the nut for tightening. Slip the bottom shock mount into the axle mounting bracket and slide the bolt through, then tighten all nuts and bolts. Next, we will install the front brake lines. First, unbolt the brake line from the caliper. Next, unbolt the line from the frame rail bracket. Reinstall by bolting the new MetalCloak brake line onto your hard line at the bracket, then bolt it into the caliper. Make sure to bleed your brakes before driving your Jeep. The next step is to install the front track bar. The fixed end of the MetalCloak JK front track bar goes into the stock frame bracket. The eye clearance bend should point toward the front bumper, up and away from the differential cover. The adjustable end of the track bar goes into the stock bracket on the axle. It may be helpful to use a ratchet strap to bring the hole into alignment. Finally, we will install the MetalCloak sway bar links. If you have a non-Rubicon edition, you will install the lower quick disconnect pin in the stock location as shown. Point the pin towards the center of the vehicle and bolt into place. Install the ball joint end of the adjustable links into the sway bar. The quick disconnect mounting bracket easily mounts along the frame rail. There is a right and left bracket. You must ensure that the mounting prong is tilting forward towards your bumper. If you have a Rubicon edition, then all you need to do is replace the stock sway bar link with the new MetalCloak sway bar link. Once completed, tighten all bolts, nuts, and jam nuts, and tighten again. Your front suspension is now finished. We will now tackle the rear suspension. Of course, the first step is to remove the stock components. First, disconnect the rear sway bar links. Disconnect the rear brake line bracket from the frame rail. Remove the rear track bar. Unbolt and remove the stock shocks. Carefully remove the stock springs and any spacers that may have been used. Next, like we did in the front, we replace the control arms one at a time. Use a 21mm socket to remove the stock control arm hardware. You will reuse this hardware to install the new Duraflex control arms. As a note, the Duraflex rear upper arm should be oriented so that the bend in the arms angle inboard to provide the most tire clearance. As mentioned before, the control arm lengths are preset for a 3.5 inch lift. However, it is recommended that you consult an alignment and suspension specialist for precise tuning and adjustment. Here are our recommended lengths. Now we are going to install the adjustable rear bump stops. Simply orient the bump stops as shown. Notice that the pattern changes for each side. See the installation video on our website for full and complete details on this unique feature. Next, we will install the rear track bar bracket. First, slide the MetalCloak track bar bracket in place and reinstall the stock bolt through the control arm. Do not fully tighten any hardware until the bracket is fully installed. Install the provided 3.5 inch long hex cap screw through the stock hole with a washer under the head of the screw. The screw is backed by a 9/16 nylon jam lock nut and washer. The MetalCloak track bar should be preset to 40 and 1/8 inch eye to eye. This length can be adjusted for your specific build or lift height. Install the MetalCloak track bar into the bracket. Use the stock nut and bolt for the frame side mount. Install the dual rate coils like we did before, with the tightly wound coils at the top and the small pigtail at the bottom. Carefully stuff them into place. It is good to make sure the coils are oriented the same for each side. Next, install the Old Man Emu rear shocks using the stock hardware. Install the bar pin side of the rear shocks into the tub of your Jeep. Do not fully tighten the bolts. Slip the bottom shock mount into the axle side mounting bracket and slide the bolt through. You may need to compress the shock to fit. Now tighten all bolts. Depending on the options you choose when purchasing your kit, you either have the sway bar drop bracket or the standard sway bar extension link. For this build, we are installing the sway bar links. Refer to our printed instructions for the drop bracket. Bolt one end of the sway bar extended link to the stock location on the axle first, then fit the other end into the stock hole of the sway bar. Tighten. Finish your suspension install by replacing the stock brake line with a new MetalCloak brake line. When installing the brake line on the frame side, be sure to install the clip to hold it all in place. Once set, tighten all hardware and then tighten again. Finally, tighten the jam nuts on all control arms. As a final reminder, we recommend that you now take your Jeep to a suspension specialist for fine tuning and alignment. Enjoy your new lifted JK. MetalCloak. It's your Jeep, only better. If you have any questions, please feel free to call us at 916-631-8071 or visit MetalCloakInstructions.com.